Hi guys, today I have my volume 3 of products I have hit panel. I didn't do those often before because I figured I didn't want to show the repeating pans, but surprisingly this time around I quickly accumulated quite a few pans. I think I have about like 10 to 15 new pans to show you this time. The first one that I did was May of 2017, and then the last one I did was March of this year. So I feel those pans definitely came a lot faster than I anticipated. I think that's mainly because of two projects I'm doing right now. One is my Project Pan Porn, the other one is Peeping Pan. Both of those projects I'm doing year-long, and I'm also doing them as a rolling style. My goal is only to hit pan. Once I hit pan, I roll them out and try to hit pan on more products. So that definitely helped me out a whole lot. I will have those two projects linked down below if you're interested to check them out. I think they're definitely a lot of fun. So today, let me just show you all the new pans that I have. And of course, the old pans that I had before, I will also have the videos linked down below, but I won't mention them here anymore. Today, let's just get into our new pans. Let's start with eyeshadow products first because I feel those are definitely exciting. There are just a lot of variety when it comes to eyeshadows. I don't think it's easy to hit pan on eyeshadows by any means, so I'm really proud of them. And the first one I'm going to show you is actually the hardest for me because this is a cream eyeshadow. I use cream eyeshadows like really slow. That's like one of my toughest project items to pan. It's just really hard for me for some reason. And this one is a color tattoo from Maybelline, and the color is Lavish Lavender. The pan is very minimal, very small, right in there in the middle. I don't know if you can tell. Maybe you can see from this side. Yeah, right there. Can you tell that little pan? So I'm really happy about this. I have never hit pan on a cream eyeshadow before. All the cream eyeshadows that I have finished before are all in those like stick form. And I have finished a potted form mini cream eyeshadow before. And this is my first full-size cream eyeshadow in a pot form that I have pan on. So I think that means a lot because I've been panning for years and this did not come easy. I'm happy about that. And then let's get into the regular powder eyeshadows. And I know a lot of those pans might look familiar to you if you watch my other project panning videos, or they might be surprised to you. You know, I can't really keep all the timing so perfect, so you're gonna see some of the things you've seen before or spoilers. I don't know. This one is a single eyeshadow from Elizabeth Mott, and it's called Pop Goes the Shadow. The color is called Champagne. It's gonna be hard to show you because this one is crumbled. Can you tell on the bottom there's a little like some piece hanging there? This one, it was kind of cheating because I didn't completely hit pan. It was more like a shattered and cracked. But I was really close to hitting pan, so I don't know. I think I'm probably gonna repress it. Because right now, whenever I put my brush in, more pieces would just fall off. It's a really soft shadow. Regardless, I do have pan, even though it does feel a little bit like cheating. Now let's get into some legit powder eyeshadow pans. So this one is a duo from Bare Minerals, and the color is called the Guilty Pleasures. That's the name of this duo. And of course, there are two shades inside that I just have pan in one of them. This one is a really good color for me. It's peachy, but at the same time, it's very yellow toned, so it's a very easy transition shade for me. It took me about a month and a half to hit pan on it, and I was really happy with it. I really like this duo. I think it's just perfect for me color-wise, and the formula is really easy to work with. The peachy shade is a little bit more on the powdery side, but you know, it doesn't matter. I think it served its purpose. I have pan out, but I don't think I would ever one day try to pan this thing because it's just easy go-to for me if I travel. So I probably would try to keep it in my collection for as long as possible. And then this one little quad that I have here is from L'Oreal. The color for the quad is called Rose for Romance. This one took me quite a while to hit pan on too, and I kind of feel I don't really care for this quad. So I just have one pan in the four shades, and this one is a pretty large pan too. The color is a medium-toned kind of shimmery pinky color. There's nothing really good about it. It's chunky, powdery, and the color payoff isn't all that great. it's easy to use just because you can use a really heavy hand, just go in there and then put it on your lids, you know. But then I don't think I really enjoy it by any means. And the other three shades are also very mediocre in this little quad. Now I have pen, I actually think I'm gonna declutter this thing. I just wanted to show you guys my pen because I did work on it, and then now I'm gonna declutter it. And then there's another quad from the same line from L'Oreal. This one is in the shade Coupa Joe. On the other hand, I really, really enjoy this quad, and I used it so much that the lid fell off. But still, this is such an amazing quad, and you can see that I have three pens in this quad now. I use those three shades almost consistently. I think last time when I did the products I've hit pen on, I've showed you one pen, that is this guy. And now this pen is significantly larger. I mainly use this in my eyebrows. I think it's a perfect shade for me. This is what I have in my brows today. And this middle guy with the little pen right here, I also use that guy in my eyebrows. I usually use the deeper color more towards the end, and then I use this lighter one at the beginning, like of the brow. So I think that's a really good combo. I really enjoy the texture, the consistency, the color. I think it just works perfectly for my brows. And I'm gonna even try to finish this deeper brown shade. I think once that one is finished, I would consider maybe panning this shade and throw away the rest. So this one, you can see there's also pan. I use this one as a transition shade on my eyelids, and I think that looks really good too. It's just like, it's such an easy go-to companion palette. I'm really happy I rediscovered this product. And then I have this palette. This one is a 9-pen palette. It's a little bit bigger. It's from NYX. It's called Loving Paris. This one was actually surprise pens to me because I wasn't really using it in a project yet. I was just trying to test it out and see if I still like it. And I hit pan on two shades by surprise. So that was really nice actually, because I think those are some of my preferred shades too. I think the two deeper ones, I use this one as a brow powder sometimes. It's rather deep, but the rest of the eight shades, I use them on my eyes. I could use all of them. This is just such an easy palette, you know? I've had it for years, and I always come back to it every once in a while just because it just provides something easy for your eyes. And it has a variety. It has some lighter pinks, deeper pinks, like berry tone colors. And it has all those warm browns, and it has a brow bone powder. It has every shade that you possibly would need. And I think it's very versatile, and I like it, you know? And I'm so happy that I came back to this time around, and I actually hit pan on two shades. That was really good for me. And then I have a little trail from Wet n Wild. This one is a limited edition trail color, I believe. It's in the color Spoiled Army Brat. I got it many years ago, and I used it a little bit. I did like it, but there were just like so many eyeshadows, right? So I naturally put it away for years. So I came back to it a couple months ago, and I hit pan on two out of the three shades here. I think this little trail is really good too. The colors are really easy to work with. They're easy to blend. The color payoff is nice, and I like the colors themselves too. I think they're more or less on the unique side. You don't see those kind of shades every day, and I just really enjoy them. So I'm gonna keep it in my collection for a little while longer. Maybe I'm thinking I will try to pan it next year. The last eyeshadows now. So this one is from my big palette. This one is All I See Is Magic from ColourPop. I love this palette. It's just so good. This is such a good palette. The colors are so unique and beautiful. You have so many options in here. I love it. I love it so much. I have pan in two shades. One is this kind of transition color. It's yellowish. And this color is called Go Wish. And I use that a ton. So I'm happy I have pan in that one. And also this shimmery pink color right here is called 1111. I don't think I've used that too much, but this one is more like a pressed glitter color, so it's a little bit more crumbly and powdery, so that definitely went away much faster. And regardless, I'm happy I have two pans in this palette. I love it. I think if one day I ever, you know, finish maybe half of the shades in this palette, I will repurchase it without a doubt. All right, now I just have four like face products now. I think this is kind of amazing because I usually think face products are easier to hit pan on because you have larger surface area to cover. But surprisingly, this time it was just a lot more eyeshadow heavy. Regardless, I'm happy with my four face product pans. So the first one here is a dual product from Marc Jacobs, and it's the Hi-Fi filter. And this one, last time I showed you one pan in the two products, but now I have pan in both. I think last time I only had pan in this bronzer and it was a small pan. Right now I have pan in both, and both of them are large pans. I'm thinking I'm gonna try to work on it more consistently, and hopefully I can finish it maybe before the summer ends. This is definitely a little bit more on the powdery side, so I'm not surprised that the pans expanded super fast, but I really want to try to finish them fast though. Another face powder product, this one really took me nearly no effort because it's so small. This is from Laura Geller. It's a Baked Balance and Brighten foundation in the color Fair. I love this product. I have used another one, a full-size one, before, and I just love the formula. This mini one is very easy to use, and the color Fair matches me really well now. This is a baked product, so the pan isn't very easy to tell, but you can see those little dots right there in the middle. That's the tile like pan that the product is baked on. So that's a decent sized pan now, actually. And this one, I don't think it's gonna last me much longer. It doesn't have much product in there anymore, so I think I'm probably gonna toss it into some project and just try to finish it. And then I have one blush. This one took me a little longer than I expected because this is my sample size Tarte blush in the color Party with the three A's. This one was a Sephora birthday gift. I've seen a lot of people pan this product, and most of the people would just say, oh, it's so easy to pan, like it's super fast and whatnot, because those like full-size Tarte blushes are really hard to pan, we all know that. But this one somehow is just much easier. So I thought I would go through this blush really fast, but it still took me like 2 months to finally hit pan, and that was only a baby pan. So I was a little bit concerned because I had like false hope, I guess. I wasn't estimating it right, and I finally have a little pan. I kind of just put it away because I was using it 2 months straight and I just needed a little break from it. But it's a very lovely blush. I think my goal is definitely try to finish it this year. The very last product, I actually just saw the pan in this product this morning, and it took me a little staring to even find the pan. This one is my Ofra Niki Tutorials Everglow Highlighter. It's a very strong highlighter, so I think that was like no joke some effort put in there to finally see the pan. And this is a very small pan. Can you tell right in there in this like middle shade? See that little pan right there? Gosh, I'm like so proud of this. I think this one is so hard to hit pan on because it is extremely shiny. This is what I have on my face today. You can see all that glow on the tip of my nose. You really cannot use a heavy hand with it, but you can see a little like dip in those two darker shades. I do use them on my eyelids sometimes. I think that helped it, you know, with hitting pan. So maybe because of that, I hit pan on it a little bit faster, but oh my goodness, I'm just so happy. Look at that little pan. Hitting pan on highlighters is definitely hard. With a light hand and consistent use, this took me quite a while to finally hit pan on, and I'm just so happy and proud of it. All right, so that's all the pans I have right now in my collection, all the new pans I have in my collection, and I'm really happy and proud of this. Like I said, I did not expect to hit pan on them so fast. This is much better than I anticipated, so I'm super happy about it. And hopefully those two projects that I mentioned to you earlier, they could help me out in the later half of the year too, and I will continue to hit pan on more products. And some of you guys even asked me before what I'm gonna do with all those products that, you know, have pan in them. For now, I'm just putting them back into my collection, well, except for a handful few that I told you I was gonna pan right away fast. But the majority of them, I'm just putting them back into my collection because right now in my collection, or at least at the beginning of 2018, I feel my collection has a lot of brand new or close to brand new products. And I was hitting a hard spot in panning because I couldn't just go with a brand new product and, you know, use like 10 month time to pan it. Like I would be so bored and I just couldn't do that. So this year my focus is try to hit pan or half use most of my products so that next year I would try to focus on them and actually try to finish them. So that's kind of my plan, and hopefully I can hit pan on a lot more products, like I said, in the next few months, and that will be really exciting. And once I have about 10 products or 10 new pans, I will come back here and then show you those new pans. And yes, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give me a like and go check out my two previous hit pan videos, and also subscribe to my channel so you can see some of my project updates. And thank you guys for watching. Bye.